Hello and welcome to the 8th video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. This is the first video in the second section of this course, Essential Practice. In this section, we are going to cover a lot of cool things After Effects can do. We are going to get hands-on and learn by undertaking a number of exercises, which later in the next section, we will use to build a project from scratch. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to manage video in After Effects and how to perform a simple video edit. Now, it's important to state at the start of this video that After Effects is not a video editing program by design. Now, that's not to say you cannot do video editing in After Effects. In this video, I'm going to show you how. But it's important to note that Adobe After Effects is primarily used for post-production. Any video you use in After Effects will typically be edited in a specialized video editing program like Adobe Premiere first, exported and then brought into After Effects. That's how I make my videos, for example. I first shoot my raw video, then edit it together in Adobe Premiere, export from there and import into After Effects. Remember, After Effects is based on compositing and works not only with video footage, but with still images, type and files brought in from other programs like Adobe Photoshop, Illustrator and 3D programs to create video presentations. What you will come to learn is that video editing in Premiere as opposed to After Effects is a far more easier task. However, when we bring in video that has been exported from other programs, we still need to edit it in After Effects to a certain degree. In this video, I'll be showing you an example of how to edit video simply in After Effects. So in this video, we're going to be covering the following topics: importing video into After Effects and editing video clips in the timeline panel. So first, I'll start by showing you what we are going to create in this video, and then I will show you how to do it. So let's get into it. So here I am in After Effects, and I have a project open demonstrating a simple video edit sequence I have prepared earlier. And here I have some footage of marine life taken at the London Aquarium. If we look in the timeline panel, we can see that this is made up of 7 video layers, and we can see the red line traveling across the timeline, indicating we are in preview mode. Looking in the timeline panel, we can see the classic layer bars, and as the red line passes over each bar, we can see how this edit looks in the composition panel above. Now, if you want to follow along with this video and create your own video edit like this, you will need to download the project folder. You can download the project folder for a small fee. The download link with instructions is in the description. The download folder comes with lots of exercise documents we will be using on this course that have been carefully developed to aid your learning experience. The folder also comes with document resources such as videos, graphics, and images you can use to build your first video presentation from scratch later on in this course. To get the full learning experience, I recommend you get the project folder. Download link with instructions is in the description. So with the project folder open, click into the S2 Essential Practice folder, into the 8th folder, Simple Video Editing, and open the video editing After Effects file, and you will have the same document I have open here. Now, if we look carefully in the timeline panel, we can see that only part of each video layer bar is highlighted, and they string together seamlessly in a stack to create this edit. This is how a typical video edit looks in After Effects. When we place video into compositions, we cannot easily cut and move parts of it around like we can in video editing programs like Premiere Pro. When we place a video file into After Effects, we have to work with its entire contents on a layer and clip which part is visible and which part is not. Okay, so with that introduction, let's see how we can create a simple edit like this in After Effects. So first, I'm going to close this project down. I'll come to File, scroll down and select Close Project. So with the blank screen here, I'm going to begin by dragging in some video files. To do this, I'm going to make sure I can see my browser window on top of the After Effects interface. In the Projects folder, I'll come into the Assets folder, into the Video folder, then into the Aquarium folder, and in here, you will find some video files. So in this instance, I'm going to select them all by clicking and dragging over them. Then drag them into the Project panel on the left of the After Effects interface. Upon release, they should all appear in the panel. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a new composition. So I'll come up to Composition at the top bar, click and select New Composition. With the Composition Settings window open, I'll name the comp to Video Edit. Next, I'll click here on the preset dropdown. Now, I'm based here in Europe, so I'm going to set this to HDTV25. If you're based in the United States, you may want to go with your regional standard, which is 29.97 frames per second. So you may want to go for HDTV29.97. So I'll select HDTV25, and this is going to result in 25 frames per second. So by clicking on this, it will set my dimensions to 1920 by 1080. Next, I'll set my duration to 35 seconds, and I'll keep the background black and click OK. Upon click, we will have a new composition to work with. So with the new composition ready, I'll place in my video. So I'll come over to the project panel, and the first video I'm going to add will be the deep blue clip. So I can do this a number of ways. I can click and drag it down into the timeline name section and release like so, and I'll just undo that. Or I can click and drag into the composition panel. As I do this, I can see the outline of the video. I'll make sure it snaps to the borders and release. And again, I'll undo that. Now another way is to use the keyboard shortcut. So with the media selected in the project panel, I can press Command/ on Mac or Control/ on PC. And this will place the video straight into the timeline panel. So here I have my first video footage as a layer in my timeline. Now if I come under the composition panel, hit the resolution factor pop-up, I'll click on half. Then I'll make sure my time indicator is at the start of my timeline and I'll press spacebar to preview my video like so. Easy. So for now, I'll click spacebar again to stop. Right, so let's get some more videos in here. So over in the project panel, this time I'm going to press and hold Command on a Mac or Control on PC and select Fish 2, 3, 5, Horse 1, Jelly 1, and Jelly 2. With them all selected, I can either press Command/ on Mac or Control/ on PC to quickly place them into my timeline panel. Or I can click and drag them over into the compositions panel. As I do this, I can see the outline of the video. I'll make sure it snaps to the borders and release. Upon release, we can see the video layers appear in the timeline. So looking closely at the layers, we can see that these clips vary in length, and we can tell this by the lengths of the bars. Now, in this instance, we only want each video clip to show for 5 seconds, so these video layers will work just fine. So with our videos in the timeline panel, now we are ready to edit. So the first video file I want to edit is Deep Blue. But right now this is set at the bottom of the layers. If I come over to the layer names, I'll click and hold the layer name for this layer and drag it to the top of the layer stack. Upon release, I can now see it on top. So if I click and drag my time indicator across this layer, the entirety of this video layer is visible. Now, if I carefully put my mouse cursor over the end of the layer bar on the right, we will see the mouse cursor icon change to arrows pointing horizontally in and out. Now, if I click and drag inwards, like so, we will notice that we are dragging in the highlighted part of the layer bar. For now, I'll drag this in to around 15 seconds, referring to the numbers in the top of the timeline ruler. Next, I'll do the same, but on the left-hand side. So I'll place my mouse cursor over the far left side of the layer bar. When the mouse cursor icon changes to arrows pointing horizontally, in and out, I'll click and drag into 10 seconds, like so. So if we look carefully, the rest of the layer bar still exists, but we have simply edited the highlighted part of the bar. Whatever is highlighted on the video bar is visible. If I click and drag my time indicator across from the beginning, we cannot see the video. But if I move it across into the highlighted area, we can now see it in the composition panel above. So that is the main principle of editing a video clip in a composition in the timeline panel. Now, I want this highlighted bit to be at the start of my composition. Next, I'll click on the highlighted area and drag left so the start of the highlighted area starts at the start of the timeline. Easy. So that's my first clip edited. Now, it's just a case of doing the same process to my other clips and placing them in the correct position. So next, I'll click and drag the next video layer up and under my first one. In this case, I want the next clip to be Jelly 1. I'll click and drag this up and under Deep Blue. Next, I'll click across on the timeline ruler so I can see my new clip in the composition panel. This time, I'm going to click and drag my layer left and right, like so, to try and find a good starting point in my composition panel above. Once I find a good starting point, I'm going to edit the layer. Now, earlier we put our mouse cursor at the end of each layer bar and dragged them in. Now, here is a quick tip. First, place the time indicator where you want to begin and press Alt Open square bracket on the keyboard. Notice the highlighted area of the clip snaps right to the time indicator. Easy. So next, I'm going to click and drag the layer under the deep blue layer. By holding Shift, the start of the highlighted area is going to snap to the start of the highlighted area above. Next, I'm going to click and drag my time indicator left while holding Shift to snap to the end of the deep blue layer above. With the jelly layer selected and my time indicator in place, I'll press Alt Close square bracket, and the highlight area is now clipped exactly the same as the layer above. Next, I'll click and drag my new edited clip layer to the right, holding Shift so the start of my new clip snaps to the end of the clip above. So now I have my two layers edited. If I click and drag the time indicator over them, we can see how that looks. So let's do this again for the next video layer, this time with the Fish 3 layer. So I'll click and drag the layer up and under the Jelly 1 MP4 layer. So I'll click and drag the layer bar over to the right. I'll click on the time ruler so I can see it. I'll find an appropriate place towards the beginning, and I'll press Alt Open square bracket to trim the clip. Like last time, I'll drag the layer across under my first clip while holding Shift to snap it in line with the top layer. I'll drag my time indicator left while holding Shift to snap to the end of the top layer. With my Fish 3 layer selected, I'll press Alt Close bracket to trim the end of the clip. Then I'll click and drag my new edited clip layer over to the right while holding Shift to snap it to the end of my second layer. Easy. And if I click and drag the time indicator over my three edited clips, we can see how that looks. So let's do this again, but this time with the Horse 1 layer. So first I'll click and drag it up and under the Fish 3 layer. I'll click and drag the bar over to the right. I'll click on the time ruler so I can see it. I'll find an appropriate place towards the beginning, or maybe in this case towards the middle, and I'll press Alt open bracket to trim the clip. Like last time, I'll drag the layer across under my first layer while holding Shift to snap in line with the top layer. I'll drag my time indicator left while holding Shift to snap to the end of the top layer. With my horse layer selected, I'll press Alt close bracket to trim the clip. Then I'll click and drag my new edited bar over to the right while holding Shift to snap it to the end of my third layer. And if I click and drag my time indicator over my four edited clips, we can see that's looking just fine. So by using this technique, we are making sure each video clip is the same length. So next, the Fish 5 video layer. I'll click and drag it up and under the horse layer. I'll click and drag the bar over to the right. I'll click on the time ruler so I can see it. I'll find an appropriate place to begin the video clip. And I'll press Alt open bracket to trim the start of the clip. I'll drag the layer across under my first layer while holding Shift to snap it in line with the top layer. I'll drag my time indicator left while holding Shift to snap to the end of the top layer. With the Fish layer selected, I'll press Alt close bracket to trim the end of the clip. Then I'll click and drag my new edited clip over to the right while holding Shift to snap it to the end of my fourth layer. So next, the Jelly 2 video layer. I'll click and drag it up and under Fish 5. I'll click and drag the bar over to the right. I'll click on the time ruler so I can see it. I'll find an appropriate place to begin the video clip, and I'll press Alt open bracket to trim the clip. I'll drag the layer across and under my first layer while holding Shift to snap it in line with the top layer. I'll drag my time indicator left while holding Shift to snap to the end of the top layer. With the Jellyfish 2 layer selected, I'll press Alt close bracket to trim the clip. Then I'll click and drag the new edited clip over to the right while holding Shift to snap it to the end of my fifth layer. Easy. Okay, so one last time. With the last layer, I'll click and drag the layer bar over to the right. I'll click the time ruler so I can see it. I'll find an appropriate place to begin the video clip, and I'll press Alt open bracket to trim the clip. I'll drag the layer across under my first layer while holding Shift to snap it in line with the top layer. I'll drag my time indicator left while holding Shift to snap to the end of the top layer. With my Jellyfish 2 layer selected, I'll press Alt close bracket to trim the end of the clip. Then I'll click and drag the new edit clip bar over to the right while holding Shift to snap it to the end of the sixth layer. And there we have our final clip in position, completing the composition video edit. So if I now click and drag the time indicator to the start of the timeline ruler, I'll make sure the resolution factor pop-up is set to full. I'll press spacebar to activate preview, and the video edit will play out just how I want it. Perfect. So that is how you can edit video in After Effects. Now, there is something else you will need to be aware of as a beginner. On occasions, you may find yourself accidentally double-clicking on a video layer in your timeline. For example, with the video edit complete, let's double-click on a video layer here. Now, upon double-click, the video will appear in another tab in the composition panel. This is a way to isolate a video layer to inspect it. In this instance, we are no longer looking at the video edit reflected in the timeline panel below. Now, in this instance, as you scroll across your timeline, you will not be able to see any of your other layers on the timeline. Now, as a beginner, you may wonder where your comp has gone. Now, don't worry, if you look carefully in the composition panel above, you will see your comp is still present, but on a tab on the left. If ever you find you have accidentally double-clicked on a video layer, you can simply close down the tab in the composition panel at the top to come back to your main comp. So remember to keep this in mind. So now you know how to manage and edit video, it's now time to start applying basic animation. In a previous episode, I discussed in-depth keyframes. In the next video, we are going to start to get more hands-on with keyframes. In the next video, I'll be discussing simple animation principles and showing you how to animate in After Effects with keyframes. So see you in the next video.